I think we've got about 3 weeks now to solve the DACA problem. The president already started on that. I think he met with half a dozen senators yesterday. We said during the shutdown that we were looking for, or we had enjoyed having discussions about DACA before the shutdown. We were going to renew discussions about DACA after the shutdown, but we would not have those discussions during the shutdown. We didn't. Importantly, and no one's mentioned this before, what Senator Schumer did was cost us several important days. Keep in mind, even though we've got about 3 weeks now before the next CR, the continuing resolution, expires, I think Congress is only going to be in town maybe 6 or 7 of those days. So the 3 days we lost over
the weekend was a big difference. I mean, he should be pulling the strings and making these guys meet and inviting them to the White House. It worked once. Then he kind of backed off. He could be doing that. You say the president is interested in DACA. What is his position on Dreamers?
Keep in mind, the president has already done every one of those things that you just listed. He's called members of the House and the Senate. He's had them down to the White House, had them again, half a dozen, I think, senators here yesterday, technically before the government
even
opened.
Numerous Republicans say he stepped away, that he wasn't an active part of this process. He was letting them handle it. And Mitch McConnell has said he doesn't know where he stands on immigration.
But be perfectly clear, we said we were going to step away if the government shut down. We said we would negotiate before a shutdown and after a shutdown, but not during the shutdown.
Then we agree. He stepped away and wasn't an active part of the negotiation. I accept your point.
And got exactly what we wanted. Sometimes not going to the table is one of the best things you can do in a negotiation. So the president got exactly what he wanted, which is he got the government funded, he got the CHIP extension, he got the delay in the taxes, and didn't have to give anything in exchange for that. But anyway, so moving forward, we do look forward to continuing the discussion.
What is his DACA position?
The position is as it has been from the very beginning. We're interested in border security. We're interested in
changing. That's not a DACA position. What's his position on Dreamers?
If you let me finish, you look at immigration.
I want you to answer that question, Mick. You know, that's what makes this interesting.
I will, but you.
All right, go ahead. Do it the way you want.
You don't get a chance to pick and choose. We want a large agreement. We want a big deal that solves the reason that we have a DACA problem in the first place. If you simply gave amnesty, whatever you want to call it, to the folks who are here, but don't solve border security, then you're simply delaying another DACA problem 10 or 15 years from now. You have to deal with this holistically. You have to deal with the entire issue of immigration at one time. So that means, I'll start with your topic, figuring out under what terms and conditions folks can stay here. Those are the DACAs, those are the Dreamers, call them what you want to, but allow them to stay here. What are those terms and conditions, and who gets to stay? Is it
what
just
are
the
they?
Dreamers?
What are his terms and conditions? Who does get to stay?
Chris, I know you won't be offended by this, but not negotiating with you on national television.
No, I just want to hear it. I tell you what, I won't say anything. Just say what his position is on it. How do they get to stay? Who gets to stay?
Again, depends on what we get in exchange. What do we get for border security? What do we get for wall? The Senator Schumer this weekend said that he gave the president everything he wanted on the wall. I've challenged that. Senator Schumer says that he insists that he gave it. We'll have a discussion. Did he really offer $20 billion in appropriated funds, or did he just offer $20 billion in authorized funds? Keep in mind, there's border security that was authorized in 2006 that Senator Schumer voted for, but that still hasn't been built yet because no one's actually appropriated the funds. So where are we on that? That's part of the discussion.
Legitimate issue. I mean, the president's not helping by going back and forth about wanting a brand new wall versus using the wall as a metaphor, as most reasonable minds see it, meaning a fence in some places, sensors, increased manpower. And it's really not tomato, tomato. The president was so strong on saying, no, I mean a big brand new wall everywhere and Mexico's going to pay for it. And clearly, or at least we hope, if there's going to be any chance of progress, that's not where he is now. But, Mick, you said something that I have to go back to.
Sure.
A wall is an inanimate object, and you can dicker about it, and you go about the money and the time and the appropriations and how it's done. I got you. Dreamers are human beings, and the idea that he will only be as generous or as loving, right, because he said he wants a bill of love, as warranted by what he gets in return does not seem like love to me.
Trying to solve the problem, though, is he's the president of the United States. He's the commander-in-chief. He's responsible not only for the well-being of the citizens, he's also now taking responsibility for helping the folks who are here under DACA temporarily, at least through March, but he's also in charge of making sure that drugs don't come in, that future illegal immigrants come in. It's not, you can't do it the way you just laid it out, Chris. You can't just say, okay, I'm going to do a deal on DACA and that's it.
Why?
Because it doesn't solve the problem.
It does for the Dreamers.
The president of the United States, doesn't solve the problem for you, for me, for everybody else. Doesn't solve the issue of drugs costing the population. You can't do it like that. You can if you want to.
You could,
but
sure.
That's not an effective way to solve the problem.
But it's an effective way to help the dreamers, and he called it a bill of love. None of that other stuff is about love. It's about security, and there are things that are important, but not the same as giving these dignity to these human beings who were brought in as children, who he says he cares about.
Look, fabulous questions. Great question. Go back in time. Ask President Obama when he had control of the White House. 60 votes in the Senate and the House. Why didn't they solve illegal immigration? Why didn't they deal with the Dreamers?
But he did the executive action to protect the Dreamers because the rest of you guys couldn't get it done. That's what a leader does, right?
Again, you are ignoring the fact that he controlled the Senate and the House, again, with 60 votes in the Senate. But go to the executive action, because I was watching either an interview you did earlier today or last night. The executive action was illegal. I know you said that it wasn't determined to be illegal.
But it never finished that process.
The deferred action against parents was determined to be illegal by the courts for the same reason
that DACA wasn't would have finished.
But if the president had allowed the litigation to go forward and the courts had undermined or had overturned DACA, it would have been instant. And what the president did was he gave Congress at least 6 months. Keep in mind, General Kelly, and I think he said this on your show before, was actually talking to the Senate as early as December of last year, so 13 months ago, saying, look, DACA is a problem. You know it's a problem. I know it's a problem. It's not going to hold up in the courts. You need to fix DACA now. That was 13 months ago, but Congress did nothing. And then the president comes in last fall and gives them another 6 months, and still we are here with nothing. So you cannot say this is the president's fault that DACA has not been fixed. He's been trying to shine a light on this from the very beginning, but it's been Congress, mostly the Senate Democrats, have been dragging their feet on this. We do look forward at the end of the day, if we want to find something positive to look on, about having this next 3 weeks to be able to focus intensely on DACA.
Right, but it will only be as generous to the Dreamers as it is what you get in return. That's what you said, right?
The president represents every person, every citizen of the United States of America. You don't get to sort of say, well, I'm going to fix DACA, but I'm not going to fix illegal immigration. That's not being presidential. That doesn't solve the problem. That's what we pay a president to do. It's what we hire a president to do, to try and get the best solutions that we can to many of our problems. Simply waving a wand and giving amnesty to 12 or 13 million people may solve a problem for them, but doesn't solve a problem for the other 300 million people who live here.
But they're not a problem for you, the Dreamers.
No, it solves the problem for them.
I know, but they are not a problem to you, this imaginary crisis that immigrants pose to the United States. Dreamers are not a problem. They're a benefit. And in fact, according to the Center for American Progress, if you get rid of them, you'd cost us $433 billion over 10 years, or $43 billion a year, in U.S. gross domestic product. You'd cost us money by getting rid of them.
You're not going to get me to disagree on the value of legal immigration. Illegal immigration is a different topic, and I'm not going to debate a Center for American Progress report on your show. Come on now, that's not even.
You don't believe the numbers?
Center for American Progress? Seriously, let's find a couple different studies on both sides of the argument. You know that I could find something from some right wing group that says the exact opposite.
Mick, you're the budget director. Do you believe that it wouldn't cost the country money if you got rid of Dreamers?
I believe that it's bad for the nation to have bad illegal immigration policies. And that's what we have right now. You do have drugs coming in. You have folks
entering
the
country illegally. Do you think if you got rid of all the Dreamers, we would lose money?
I think you need to solve our immigration problems.
Why won't you say, yes, we'd lose money?
Why?
What's wrong with that? Why not say something that's positive about these people? Why can't you do it?
Let me ask you a question. Why won't you just agree that we need to have a holistic immigration solution so that we don't have this problem, so that your kids and my kids aren't having this same debate 25 years from now? What's wrong with that?
What's wrong with it is that you're lumping in something that is an exigency with a human cost right now with things that are not on that same sphere of importance. The border matters, but you guys talk as if it was wide open. It isn't wide open. It's disrespectful to the good men and women who are keeping it safe.
I can say this in good conscience because I was accused of the same thing. Lumping in an exigency is taking a DACA discussion and trying to force it into a fiscal government shutdown discussion. I got accused of the same thing, supposedly for interjecting Obamacare into a financial discussion in 2013. That's an exigency. That's taking something that's not related. Border security and the status of folks who came here illegally are absolutely and inextricably linked. Those two things go together. You have one because you have the other. Taking DACA and forcing it on whether or not we're going to pay the troops or the federal workers for a week, that's an exigency.
But that didn't have to happen either, right? The Democrats offered to put something on the floor to keep the military paid, and McConnell wouldn't put it on the floor. What about that? Actually,
well, those were a bunch, and you and I both know those were a bunch of procedural motions that both sides objected to. Mr. McConnell asked for a quicker consideration instead of waiting till Monday. We could have opened this government, by the way, even after it closed, as early as Saturday night or early Sunday morning, but we've not talked about this. I absolutely believe there was some political motivation to deprive the president of that opportunity over his anniversary weekend, his first year in office, of the ability to talk about all the successes that the administration has had in the first year, but they denied the ability to do that. I think that was a political motivation, but certainly there was a bunch of different
votes. There's always political motivation in a shutdown. It was the same with you guys in 2013. You had a senator reading Green Eggs and Ham on the floor of the Senate. It was all about politics. Let me ask you something.
The difference, though, this time is, Chris, we won this time.
Well, if you see it as winning, getting 16 days and this incredible dysfunction of back and forth and dealing with the Dreamers or not dealing with them, and what do you get in exchange? We'll see what kind of progress comes out of it. It certainly avoided a crisis, but for how long? One bill or two? What are we going to get?
I'm sorry, in terms of
what? Will it be one bill? Quickly, I know you have to go. Will it be one bill or two? Will one be on the budgetary issues and one that is separate be on immigration, or will they be conjoined again?
I don't know the answer to that question. Okay. So in fairness, I know they'll all be discussed together because they are now sort of linked. So there'll be discussion about DACA, discussion about raising the caps, discussion about several other things. But whether or not it's one bill or two, I think it's too early to say. And it's probably not relevant.
Right. And of course, it's also up to McConnell and keeping his promise. Let's see if that February 8th date, if they don't make a deal, if he does trigger the vote.
By the way, you should ask Shutdown Schumer if that was the same promise that McConnell gave to Flake, because my understanding was that was going to happen anyway. That was a promise that was given to Senator Flake as part of the tax discussion. So it's another thing that Schumer says that he got yesterday that he didn't get. Mm.
Shutdown Schumer, you know, it's the same hashtag that Russian bots are using all the time, just for what it's worth. Russian bots.
Yeah, that's... I'm not a Russian bot, I can assure you of that. I'm the director of office.
I believe you. I see you right now. And it is good to see you, as always, Mick. You're always welcome here to discuss what matters to the American people.
Thanks, Chris.
Be well.